to Tiny Trullo. This is my land. I have two plots of land. The first one I bought is this one with the Trullo. And then later I bought the neighbor's land, this plot. And together it's about 1 hectare. And the reason why I'm explaining the two lands is because you can see a difference in the trees. And I will explain to you how the trees are doing. Because as you may have heard, Puglia is hit by the Xylella bacteria. And I think over 20 million olive trees have already died. And of course, I don't want my olive trees to die, but nobody knows how we can stop the disease from killing all these millions and thousand years old olive trees. So I'm doing my best. For example, this is one of my trees of about 200 years old. You can tell by the trunk how old it is. And you can tell by the sign here that it has been adopted. Some people adopt an olive tree for themselves or for their company or for a loved one or for somebody who's not here anymore. And in that way, they support me in maintaining the trees. And also they get olive oil from their own tree and a cutting board when we prune the trees. And we have to prune the trees. This tree used to be 2 times as big, full of leaves, but the sun cannot enter. And it's better for the tree if it's a little bit shorter so it can use its energy to grow and to grow olives, of course. So what I've done with pain in my heart 3 years ago, I pruned the trees on my first land. And that's why you see that there is more sunlight coming in the middle. All olive trees have basically 3 big branches, and in between the sun should be able to enter. And you can tell that this tree is getting more healthy because you see light green leaves and you see olives grow. These are the olives. It's now May, and in November, October, November, this will be olives. This is my hope. I've planted 60 new olive trees of a race that's resistant to Xylella. But as you can see, they're very thin. They're like this. This is a 2-year-old olive tree. And this one is about 50 years old. When I bought this land, I thought this was a small tree, but now I appreciate the 50 years. It's a real tree and it's already giving olives. So it's also a matter of perspective. A few years ago, I thought this tree doesn't count because it's not as big as the others. And now I'm happy I have a few of those, because this is the land that I bought later. These trees were already on the land. And they were in bad shape. It's really sad. We've had to prune them a lot. You see, there's hardly any leaves left. And this is a sign of Xylella. You see dead leaves first, and then you see parts with no leaves. You see, it's not as full of leaves as the other trees, but the healthy parts of the tree are growing olives, and there's a lot of olives. So the parts of the tree that are healthy are really healthy, but they're next to part of the tree that are not so healthy. You see, this part is losing its leaves. Because what the Xylella bacteria is doing, it's going into the veins of the tree, the sap stream, and it narrows the veins. So it doesn't get the water or the nutrients. So even if it's raining, the parts of the tree that are affected are just drying out from the inside, and that's horrible. So this is where my land ends and the neighbor's land begins. And if you look at this tree, it's so affected by Xylella, it's already 2/3 dead. And it's because they don't prune the trees. Look how big they are. My trees used to be this big. And then the tree loses its energy and it cannot defend itself as well. And it's not proven that pruning is the solution, but so far the fields that have more maintenance are doing relatively better, because we don't want our trees to look like this. So this is one of the trees on my original land. And you can see after pruning it 3 years ago, it's getting a lot bigger again. So all the measures I've taken, I've hired a tree doctor to prune the trees in the best way. I've stopped opening the land because many people turn the earth upside down, but then the land loses its precious humidity. I've grown beans on the land to add extra nutrients. I use like special organic fertilizer. I talk to the trees. I play Italian opera to the trees. I do anything I can to try to support them, because the only thing we can hope for is more time. There's no solution, but if we manage to stretch the time that they survived Xylella, maybe they will become resistant, and that's what I'm hoping for. So as you can see, just in case, I've planted a lot of new olive trees, but I hope they will just be the little sisters of those big, magnificent trees, and that we all can enjoy for a long time the trees that have been here for 200, 300, sometimes 1,000 years. So let's hope.